Hello everyone, with me today is the Siempre from Dapper Cigar Company, and you are watching Oakland Tobacconist. If you're interested in the Siempre or any other Dapper cigar, go ahead and check us out at oaklandtobacconist.com. So with me today is a very special cigar. I've had the privilege of trying this multiple times. I figured it is time to review it because it is so phenomenal. I love the interpretation when someone takes a type of tobacco and it's typically on the more mild and medium side and then pushes it to its limit, medium plus, full. So with me today is the Siempre. Dapper Cigar Company has two Siempres out there. There is this one and then the Rosado. This is the original release before the Rosado, and that is the orange label Siempre. It uses a Ecuadorian sun-grown Sumatra. We've seen a lot of different types of Sumatras out there. There's the Pony from Stallone. There's also the Judge from My Father's Cigars. There's the Cedris from Southern Draw, and there is the Siempre sun-grown Sumatra. This cigar has a very oily appearance on the wrapper leaf. It is quite textured as well. Some seams that are quite visible and rather veiny up and down. From just seeing it from afar, I would say it's a Maduro. I don't know if it's quite a Maduro because of the composition if you look closer, but it looks fermented almost to the Maduro shade. So this one right here is in the Corona size, smaller size, but I like the concentration of the flavor, and we're gonna go ahead and try it out with a cut and a light and see where that lands us. First, we'll try it out on the cold draw. Definitely earthy, almost like a pie crusty element to it. Not too much pepper, at least no spice. So we're gonna go ahead and get this toasted and see where it takes us. Actually, I had a question. Can you burn a cigar while you're toasting it? The answer is yes. If you put it right there on the flame, it's gonna scorch that tobacco much higher. So when you're toasting a cigar, I would always advise keep it a little bit elevated above that blue flame. Draw is perfect, a lot of flavor. Retro, this is really interesting to me. You have pepper in the beginning on your palate, and then the retrohale, nothing. Like, very easy, very smooth on that retrohale. Typically, it's reversed. You get all that pepper up in your nose when you retro. A little bit of sweetness, also some of that like pie crustiness, as I had mentioned, definitely earthy as well. Smoke output is perfect. Draw is perfect. There's almost like this cayenne pepper, like chocolate thing happening right here. Like, I almost think if like you have like, I don't know, box made brownies, but then you put a little bit of cayenne on top, or maybe I'm thinking red velvet, like devil cake. It's faint. I wouldn't say that's the most prominent flavor I'm getting, but it's definitely one in that mix. So, Dapper Cigar Company. Dapper Cigar was released by a gentleman by the name of Ian Reith, and he's actually here in Fresno, California, released with the Cobra series, and then later he added to his portfolio. One of his most popular is the La Madrina, which is the sort of like skeleton hand holding a rose. That one's more on the natural side. Good kick of tobacco on the back end as far as like nicotine strength, but it's also more mild on the palate. He's got his Borracho San Andreas, Borracho Broadleaf, and then his Siempre twins. This one, which is the Ecuadorian sun-grown Sumatra, and then the Rosado as well, which is like the white and black label. The thing I enjoy about this too is it's using a binder that is a Connecticut Broadleaf. Anytime it's in some sort of recipe, it's always gonna be a favorite of mine. We're gonna keep puffing on this, and then we're gonna see where it lands us when we get into our second third. Okay, so we are back on the Siempre into the second third. Unfortunately, the ash did drop. I had to set it down. The burn has been magnificent. Not had to touch it up once. The tobacco burning rate is great. We're about, probably about 20 or so minutes in here. I'm definitely getting more of a bready note. I have this like bready, sourdoughy sweetness to it when you first take a puff. Also a little bit of earth that's mixed in there. And then on the finish, a more pepper. It's got like this peppery finish to it. Has its signature sun-grown spice to it. And a little bit of maybe cocoa or black coffee, but that's definitely on the back side. I'm gonna try another puff for second impressions. Still getting a lot of that sourdough bread note. Almost like a Maybe if like you had like a little bit of sourdough with some cinnamon on it, because it finishes with that pepper heat, but also a little bit of that sweetness. So I'm gonna say right now too, it's in that medium plus to full in strength. The flavors and the strength both ramping up as I continue to smoke this down the line. We're gonna see where it lands us on the final third as we come back to it. Okay, we are in the final third. And just about to take the band off. Burn has continued to be amazing. Smoke output great. Let me go ahead and try to pinch this off. Oh, lost the ash. Just gonna go ahead and slide that off. So in the closing note, definitely medium plus strength. A little bit of that cocoa and earth, more of that bready note. It's like a sweet sourdough bready note. And the pepper is kind of sedated a little bit. So I'm getting more sweetness than I am getting like spice or pepper aggression. But definitely a really good cigar. I would love to try this out with some kind of like Dominican rum type of thing to kind of bring forth more of that sweetness. But there's also some of those coffee notes in the back end too. But overall, very good burn rate, good construction. So it's one of those cigars that it is a play between sweetness and spice. But typically when we see that sweetness and spice, you almost have like Aganorsa has like a cherry aspect note sweetness to it, or a cocoa sweetness and spice. This is more of that like bready sourdough, maybe even pie crusty type of sweetness. So it's not directly in your face, but it's there for sure. I could see this going well with something sweeter, something like a rum or like a single malt on the Highland side, or a sherry cask finish, that sort of thing, to bring even more of that sweetness forward if that's what you're looking for. So in conclusion, medium plus, great construction. And so that is the Siempre from Dapper Cigar Company. Thank you once again for smoking along with us here at Oakland Tobacconist.